Them is giving up and giving in. Tell me, in this house of mine, nothing ever comes without a consequence or cost. Tell me, will the stars align? Will heaven step in? Will it save us from our sin? Will it? Cause this house of mine stands strong. That's the price you pay. Leave behind your heart. What's happening? Looking through the glass, find the wrong within the past. Knowing we are the youth, caught until it bleeds out of world without the peace. Face a bit of the truth, the truth. That's the price you pay.
All right. Okie dokie, let's get this going, huh? Need it to go this way just a little bit, ever so slightly. Wish it was a little easier to adjust this fucking camera.
Oh.
All right, I think we're going to be calling that good. Down just a little bit. All right, I think that's it. I'm gonna go get a fucking bowl. All right, everybody. Well, welcome in. We're going to do some leg stuff today. Trying to do some supersets. It's not going to be too heavy. I'm pretty sore from our challenge thing on Saturday. I did 721 squats in 30 minutes. Just body weight, but still, I think that's pretty fucking impressive. Oh, it was fun. We had a blast. We had a good time. We had a pretty good time. So, I'm gonna kind of plan my workout real quick too. So I have a somewhat of a structure to follow before I actually get going. I think we're gonna make sure to try and really focus on tempoing out our reps too. I really want to do this, like, and make sure we increase that time under tension, right? Like, so we want to make sure to have maximum time under tension. And we're going to do supersets. So I'm thinking somewhere in the neighborhood of like 15 to 20 reps per exercise. So we're definitely going to have some volume in there. It'll be a good workout. I'm pretty sore, so we're going to kind of keep it light. So I always think that a good warm-up for legs is kind of like jump rope, I mean, riding the bike, little stair-stepping, jogging. I don't know, you can do really anything. I don't know, I like to try and burn about, I don't know, like 100 calories or so before I start working out. Or, you know, like 5 to 10 minutes of warm-up exercises. And then, you know, that can even be like stretching too, right? Like some good stretches are also very, very useful. All right. Wonder if the heart rate's gonna work today. This time, this morning it was real wonky. How's everybody's Monday going? Hope everybody's doing good. You know, you guys, if anybody's here and you're new, well, you know, say hello if you haven't before. Otherwise, it's just me talking to myself here. Which, I mean, I guess I could do pretty good at that. I mean, when it's just me talking, there's nobody to argue with me. So, I guess I'm always right. Hey, how my toes. My toes, man. I gotta refresh this real quick. Yeah. I like Wi-Fi is just being really weird today. Weird. All right, whatever. 61 calories. All right, we're gonna change it. There's a couple things I wanna try today. Things that I've seen, stuff I've seen. And I don't know, maybe this band will actually come in useful. Probably too big. Like, I'm just thinking about the amount of stretch. Probably this one.
Snowy_cake_wolf said, "Hello, Commando."
Is this? Who's in here? Why is Twitch chat not working for me? Like, Cake Wolf? Can we Cake Wolf? Is that what I heard? Hold on, let me open up my chat again for the third time. My network is totally fucking up today. Just don't want to load anything. I guess I'm lucky I'm able to stream. How are you? Welcome in. Yeah. Heard it that time. I'm on like a super big delay. Weird. It is.
I'm good about to start my workout.
What are you doing today? I'm trying to do something I saw. Like, I have issues with my hips. And I'm
core.
Ooh, there you go. And so there's this guy that I've been following on YouTube, is Squat University, and he's a personal trainer, physical therapist, and
I hate core.
Has some recommendations for hip. Oh, don't catch a nut. All right.
Going well, Commando.
Hold on.
Doing aspirin.
I gotta pull my mic. Definitely be better to do in leggings. Oh, fuck. So. The idea behind this is to, like,
don't hit
you're wanting to pull and pull, right? So like you pull and by pulling, you're pulling into the band and the band is able to open your hip in a way that I think you could never ever do.
Yeah.
And then you hold it. It's literally like, I feel it working. It hits me right back here. Ooh, the holds are tough.
Out and start my core nice and easy. Laughing face.
Oh. All right, we're gonna have to do the other side. Head out and start my core nice and easy. Don't hit your crotch. I know, I gotta be careful down there.
Go easy.
Now, honestly though, it does work. Like my problem is If I lay down and I like if I lay down like this, right, this is the best way I can say, and I have my legs like this, if I lift this leg, there's nothing, right, just solid. If I do it with this leg, there's a pop every time, right here, I'm right at the point where my hip's about to pop. It hasn't yet. There it went. It popped. Every time. Snowy without
underscore
fail.
Underscore wolf said.
Like.
Cakes.
Cakes. Campy, you like them cakes? Dude, hey, you know what? I got news about gains, Campy. I am now in the 40-inch plus club, bro. Hey, all them deadlifts been paying off.
XD.
I did a workout once, dude. I was all the way up to 41 inches. I got a 1-inch pump.
Abby said, building up the bakery.
Gotta build it. This side is not my problem side. However, I'm gonna keep doing this anyways on this side too. Those actually work really good. Like them. I like them. Building up the bakery, dude. Baking the cakes. Right. Gotta do it. Hold on. It'll blow my nose. Soon enough, when I stop fucking procrastinating, I will make a goddamn jig and I'll cut some fucking handles in this box and we'll stain it, and then I'll have a plyo box out here and I'll be able to start doing glute bridges too. That'll be awesome. I have a barbell. I mean, I have the barbell. I got plates. I think I can go up to 380. I think I can go up to 380 pounds with all the weight and all the plates that I have. I'm pretty sure it all fits on the bar. I haven't actually tested that. Maybe it doesn't. I don't know. I mean, I know I've gotten 315 on there because I've done that. What is up with my phone, man? We're gonna do this one more time. This one from not my state.
On my fucking state. What's popping, big man?
I mean, aside from like just so many issues with Twitch on every device that I try and use it on, like not connecting, slow to connect, just can't connect to chat on my phone. I don't see that message on my phone at all, only here. And I had to load that page like 3 times. Dude, Twitch is bugging. Either Twitch or my.
What a pain in the ass.
Yeah, I know. I don't know. It's just weird, right? Yeah. This morning I woke up and I had issues. I know. My audio sounded all crackly and stuff. Like it was like, and then I fixed the crackliness, but then it was quiet, and it didn't want to be loud. It was like I was talking from like over there, barely, you know, like it's just stupid, man. So I rebooted my computer, and that took like 15 minutes just to reboot the damn thing. So I haven't had this issue for like a month and a half. Now all of a sudden it's back. You know, I ran memory tests and stuff and nothing came back as bad. So I don't know, man. I still think it's probably my motherboard or something. I have no idea, dude. But this afternoon it seemed to work out just fine. So whatever. I don't care. I don't give a shit. I'm doing stuff and things.
Computer.
We're gonna go into another set of these things, and then I think we're actually gonna do. Hold on a second. I gotta make sure not to catch a nut. Just give me a second, dude. I just requires focus here. You're like, what in the fuck are you doing, dude? Hold on, dude. I gotta adjust. Can't catch a ball. Okay.
Nothing too fancy, but has like an i7 or i8 with 64 gigs RAM, maybe like $800 or so.
Yeah, let me go for that I-8. Is there an I-8?
I-9 even.
Ah. I don't think they do. Do they have an i8 processor though? Like, is there actually, was there an i8 line? I don't ever remember seeing any i8s. I remember seeing i7s, i5s, i9s.
I think there was, but they named it like a 470 or something.
Is that what it was? Like a different knockoff line or some shit?
No i8.
Yeah, so basically no i8. I don't remember, I was gonna say, I don't remember ever. Same with the i6, right? There was really like no i6. What the fuck's up with that? You know?
No, but there are like half a dozen chipsets between i5 and i9.
Yeah, I know. I have an i9 9900K.
Back up, back up. Tell me what you gonna do now. Revenge, now free back.
That's my processor. I got, I think I only have
your bots. They know you know me and they hate me, so they are out to get you now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. They know. They know.
Applying to some jobs that people sent me, see what comes of it.
Let's see how this feels. Yeah. We're gonna take it a little lighter than that. I think we'll put on 25. This should be good.
What's the difference between a Catholic priest and us? It?
Oh my God.
Wait until you're 12 before it comes on your face.
Eagle Scout survival tips said, well.
Might be. Oh man.
Ventures. Damn. Perverted.
Jesus!
What up at Eagle Scout underscore survival underscore tips? Eagle Scout survival tips said, at adventures for not much, just got off work, you. I stayed at work a bit longer due to getting ready for this weekend.
Yeah, the weekend is... Oh, this is the weekend, huh? Oh, boy.
Yep, over soccer 80 teams this weekend.
Oh, yeah. Oh, hey. I can hardly put my fucking legs on this because they're so sore. Dude, I'm sore, man. Monday's leg day. Yeah, over 80 fucking teams, dude. That's insane, man. That's a lot of teams. So I got a new game. It's called The Front. The Front. If you like survival crafter, survival craft, PvP,
yeah,
builder.
You told me you were playing that.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome. I'm digging it, dude. Like, it's a dangerous game for me. I don't know. It might not be as dangerous as Ark, but it's pretty cool, dude.
I will have
I have a couple friends that have it too, and you know, we got into Ark quite a bit, so. Dude, I think it's on PC only. You know, so you'll have to get your computer fixed, but it's badass.
Okay.
It's a lot like Ark. It's a lot like Rust. It's like they took Ark and Rust and it had a baby.
To look it up.
And then they added in a tower defense aspect to it. Yeah? Like that? Makes sense? Makes sense. Totally. Just imagine Ark if it was also a tower defense game. Yeah? Pretty dope.
So then dinosaurs also. JK, JK.
Dude, my legs are sore. After this, we're gonna roll around on the ground some more and do some stuff down there. Oh yeah, baby. Oh.
Some stuff down there. Oh yeah, baby.
Yeah.
Out of context, yep. That is bad for you.
Oh boy. Oh yeah, baby. Oh, that's funny. All right, let's see. Oops. Wrong scene. That's the one. See. All right. I still, my phone won't connect to chat, dude. It's weird. It won't connect to Twitch chat. I can see my stream. All right, so what these are, I forgot what they're called already, but you lay down on your side in like a plank position. Weird. Like this, right? And then you lift this leg.
In Far Cry 5, there is a testicle eating festival, and one mission is to get balls from certain animal types so they can be cooked and ate.
Oh yeah, I beat it. I got the testicles.
I didn't yet then yet, but still.
You haven't gotten there yet? Dude, there's a bunch of crazy shit in that game.
Didn't get them yet, I meant.
I mean, I like, I enjoy the Far Cry games. They're pretty fun. I'm Ubisoft.
I'm on the mission, but didn't do it yet.
Yeah. Ubisoft has been like one of my favorite developers for a while. But like, I don't know, man. They really kind of like, they have dropped the ball, dude.
There is one character in Far Cry 5 that talks shit about the Far Cry franchise, LUL.
You know, you can beat the game at the very beginning. You can literally get the credits to roll. I feel like mine are way too fast. And I need to come back with my foot more. Like, let me look at this video again. Hold on. Oh, this is a little bit different. Never mind, I'm not on the right video. I gotta find it, hold on. There we go. I mean, I guess I gotta analyze this move a little bit more. Maybe I need to. Okay. So, part of it is like, I got it now. Wow, that's a lot different. So we're working this one, the cheek that's down. It's kind of an interesting move to do because you are like, it's hard. Once you figure it out, though, it's all golden. It's hard to explain. But what I was doing wrong is I was just kind of going like that. But what you need to do is go like that. Like, lower that hip, that makes a big difference if you're doing that.
BRB, getting food real quick.
I'll be back.
Yeah, no worries. Uh, man. So this is supposed to target the glute, and I think it were targeting the lower one that's more to the ground. A little bit of both though. And we're also working like this rotation in the hip. So we're really stretching this hip open because we're like forcing the body kind of back into the ground. It's a really good one. I think this is definitely one that I'm probably gonna do a lot more of. And those resistance band, like lateral stretch moves, those are pretty good too. Really easy to do. Yeah, I've always liked to do these kind of stretches too, where you like kind of just sit back on your leg and then lean forward. I feel that does help too. And it definitely highlights my immobilities too. Because like, let's say, for example, if I go on this side, as opposed to, you see what I mean? Like, my body just can't. That's crazy, man. Hold on. So look, if I go this way, I'm good, right? But if I go this way, like, I can square myself up still, right? And there's nothing really different. With this, I'm looking this fucking way. I can't. And if I do, I'm wanting to fall over. You see? Weird. That's the imbalance that I'm talking about. Like, this is the issue that I have. And it comes from the hip somewhere. And I don't know where exactly or what exactly to do to make it better, right? I'm not sure. Just not sure. Really wish that Twitch would be working. They're just reconnecting to chat. Let me just close down Twitch completely. Reopen it up, but it doesn't want to close. Like it doesn't actually close the app. Let me go into my settings. Apps, which here, there we go. Literally, dude, I had to go into my phone and force stop the app. Hold on, let's see if this worked now. I don't think it's working. What a dumb app. That was like the shittiest workout ever in a long time. My legs are sore. I didn't realize how sore they were until I started trying to lift weight. Like, there's just no way. Just no way. I think it might be time to go eat some food. I haven't eaten anything all day. That's probably another reason why my energy is kind of shit. I had a protein shake this morning, but that was it.
Rock said, hey, good afternoon, what's up?
Oh, you know. Right now, not me. I had a good leg day. Hey, I got this, there's that, you know, I was telling you about that squat university, right? There's these two exercises that I tried today. One.
Liberty Street Rock said, that's a good thing you're on camera.
Yeah. One of the things that I did, you take a band and you tie it back to something. Like this, right? And you stick your leg through. very carefully.
At Adventures for good afternoon, thumbs up, okay hand.
You pull it, and then you come here and like turn away from it just a little bit, and then hold that. And I'm gonna try this for myself for a while, because I think like I've always had this weird hip issue. Max, what are you doing, huh? Oh, big stretch. Big stretch. Oh yeah, huh? Oh Max. Oh Max. Big stretch, huh? Yeah. You want some loves? He's like, hold me. Help me, hold me. But only for a minute. He wants pets. He wants the pets. Max, don't mess with my camera. Don't you mess with my camera. He walks by and he thinks I'm gonna pet him. He expects it. Did you see that shit? Max, what do you need? Are you out of food? Do you want some food? What do you need? Oh, Max. Yeah. So that was one of the exercises. And then another one is what I was actually just doing, but I wasn't doing it when you, it's called, I don't know what it's called, but you lay down on your side, like in a plank, like in a side plank position with your knee bent back like this. And you lift this leg and you want to reach out with this arm and kick back while pushing your butt like down towards your heel. So you want to push like that. Takes a little bit of focus to hit the right spot. You really should be stretching your hip as you're driving it down. Like it should open this hip up because you're also twisting this way. So like you would essentially be like laying on your leg, right? Like that. And supposed to be a really good one for like the glute. Better than a banded kickback, which I've been doing a lot of banded kickbacks because I thought maybe that would help strengthen like the area that I'm always like, it's always tight with me, you know? I don't know. So I'm just trying to figure this all out. No idea. But we had a decent little leg day. It wasn't too intense. It was mostly just I did a few sets of those exercises for like some hip mobility. And then I did some leg extensions and leg curls in a superset. And that was absolutely brutal. But I didn't do it. It wasn't even that heavy. It was just brutal. My legs are hamburgered. But the hip stuff was really good. Like the hip mobility stuff was like super good. And it didn't hurt or anything like that. Putting the judge to sleep. Yeah. Let me go warm up some food. You guys wanna see? What should it be? What should it be? Ooh. The choices, man. I went with potatoes this week. I put them in my meals. Had to do it. Yep. Add to do it. How'd your meal prep turn out, Liberty? What did you end up making? I did have a decent day today as far as legs. I feel like I got a good stretch, you know? Something that was kind of much needed. I stretched a bit this morning. Oh, I was saying, what your meal prep yesterday, it went pretty good? I think you already told me maybe this morning what you had made. You made like meatballs, right? What kind of meatballs did you make?
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah. You know, oh, I gotta switch my camera. You were talking about shepherd's pie.
I made ground beef homemade, all my own spices.
Yeah, nice. I like that. See, what we do with all our leftovers, man, is we just take them and we stick them in the freezer. But I have a vacuum. I have a vacuum sealer, like a food saver. And check this out. This is literally one of my servings of shepherd's pie. There's some peas and carrots, potatoes, cauliflower, turkey, I think. Looks like this might be turkey. I made some with turkey.
Meatballs, hamburger, shepherd's pie is barbecued chicken breast.
Made all the own spices. Nice, dude, yeah. Shepherd's pie. What do you throw in your shepherd's pie? I'm curious. I mean, it's I keep it pretty basic and pretty simple. Like for mine, I have like a ground beef or ground turkey or something like that. And then,
yeah, same here, basic corn, mashed potatoes, ground beef, and then all my own spices.
Yeah.
Spices, LOL.
See, I don't really use spices. Like, what do you mean by all your own spices? Like just like, you know, stuff that you make, like chili powder, or like what do you put in there? So what I'll do sometimes is I'll either make like a white gravy, right? Which is literally like just cornstarch, or you can use a can of like cream of mushroom soup, or any like condensed cream soups are good to throw in there. Those are definitely gonna be higher in sodium and preservatives. You know, it's better to make your own spice, you know, blend or whatever, right? Spices. Spaces.
Okay. I throw in
black pepper, paprika, cayenne, pepper, chili powder, yeah.
Barbecue powder.
That sounds good.
Everything is a dash.
Everything is a dash. Yeah, just a dash of this, a dash of that. Dash, dash, dash. I know how it goes. You know, that's the fun part, man. You know, dashing it all together. Yeah, I usually keep mine fairly simple. I'll just do like salt and pepper. And maybe like if we want to spice it up, I use like red pepper flakes or something. But like I would probably use all of those too. Like, you know, pretty simple. Paprika is always a great addition to stuff if you want to get like a nice kind of smoky flavor, you know. Cayenne pepper can bring the heat a little bit. Never use barbecue powder though. I do have some Cajun spice that I keep around. Usually I have that on hand. But yeah, that sounds good.
And sometimes the secret weapon.
The secret weapon. And sometimes the secret weapon. Parmesan cheese. Yeah. Yeah, that sounds good. They're really easy. To do. I mean, most people like really love them. I think people overthink recipes, right? They think that things need to be more difficult than they are. I'd say that most high dollar restaurants that you actually go and eat at, the recipes are pretty freaking basic. There are some where they like, you know,
it's just
make very complicated and complex stuff. Yeah, you do follow a recipe, but it's just my own. Yeah. Yeah, have you checked out Samsung Foods? You really ought to check it out. I'm just like, if you haven't checked it out already, you definitely should, because like for keeping recipes, man, I don't know how you like, you know, if you just have like a bunch of, my mom had 3x5 cards, you know.
Was when he baked or cooked, he'd throw everything in, including the kitchen sink, and just let the crumbs fall where they fall.
Yeah, that's kind of how that's kind of how my dad my dad was too, you know. He'd just kind of like experiment. What does that say? What did the father tomato say to the baby tomato? Catch up. I don't know if that's funnier or
good one.
You're about to be ketchup, kid. damn. When I make meatballs, I have a pretty good turkey meatball recipe. And I usually just use panko breadcrumbs. If I don't want to use breadcrumbs, I will use rice instead. No, like
I use my own, grind up my own bread and the mixer.
Yeah, I like the pankos because I don't know, they're really good, and I've done that before though. made my own breadcrumbs and made my own croutons. I made my own croutons on the smoker one time. Oh my God, they were so good. They were the best croutons ever. I took sourdough and I chopped it up into little cubes. And then I made this buttery like sauce and I like mixed it all around in the bread, and my dad had these smoker screens for his Traeger, and we covered the whole entire top, and so I just turned the Traeger down really, really low on smoke, right? And then I put the breadcrumbs in there. It ran for like 160, and I'd kind of shake them up every now and again. They were so good. Oh yeah, work phone call. I'm gonna go get my food and go inside and eat. Make you guys jealous. Grab mashed potatoes.
Adventure Seeker said, okay, done with the latest round of job apps.
Heck yeah. I go get my food.
Going to do some of my digital marketing cert with Google on Coursera. I'm halfway through the second course, and there are 7 cert/courses total.
Would you like to see just a little something? Just a little something. What I want you to want, what I want you to feel. But it's like no matter what I do, I can't convince you to just believe this is real. So let go, watching you turn your back like you always do. Face away and pretend that I'm not, but I'll be here because you're all that I got. I can't fade the way I did before. Don't turn your back on me. I won't be ignored. Time won't change this damage anymore. Don't turn your back on me. I won't be ignored. A little bit insecure, a little unconfident, because you don't understand to do what I can, but sometimes it don't make sense. I am what you never want to say, but I've never had a doubt. It's like no matter what I do, I can't convince you for once just to hear me out. So let go, watching you turn your back.
He'll keep ya up, gonna knock out some coursework. Education RULZ.
To figure out what the hell is going on with this computer here. Yeah, I'm gonna play some games. Eat some food, play some games. Jaden is homesick, so. What do you need? Let me go see if you need something. Ooh, I need salsa. Salsa from the Mamacita's Mamacita. Yeah? This stuff, dude. Homemade chili. That's just like the top of a chili. Yep. Totally. Oh my god, dude. Okay, see what we added? All that salsa. Mmm. Yes. Brussels sprouts, carrots, tomatoes. Potatoes. Go out at night. I wait till 2, then I turn out the light. This rejection got me so low. She keeps it up. I just want to. You taking any medicine? I think we have that Alka-Seltzer, and then there's some daytime stuff, I believe. If I were you, I'd probably just take Alka-Seltzer, to be honest. I actually find it to be the most helpful. But you gonna make yourself some food?
Oh, man.